Hello students, today we are going to start a new chapter, heat and its effects. So first of all, we have to understand what is heat. Actually, heat is a form of energy and also known as thermal energy. Here, many other forms of energy can be converted to heat energy, and heat energy can also be converted into other forms of energy. A few examples I am going to share here. When you rub your hands together, mechanical energy gets converted to heat energy and your hands become warm. Now, when fuel is burnt, chemical energy stored in the fuel gets converted to heat energy. Now the next. The heat energy of burning petrol is converted to mechanical energy in a car. In an electric heater, electrical energy is converted to heat energy. In a powerhouse, heat energy of burning coal is converted into electrical energy. So, these were the different forms of energy converting to one another. When a solid, a liquid, or a gas is heated, its molecules gain energy and start moving faster. The more we heat the substance, the faster its molecules move. Heat energy is therefore the energy of movement of molecules. Now, next is effects of heat. To observe effects of heat, we take a vessel and fill the vessel up to the brim with water. Brim means lip of a container. Now we drop a few pieces of vegetables in it, then heat the vessel and observe the changes that happen. You will observe the following changes. First, the water becomes warmer, that is, its temperature rises. Thus, heat causes increase in temperature. Next, as the water heats up, some of it overflows. That means its volume increases. Thus, heat causes expansion. Next, as the water boils, steam comes out of the water. That is, water changes its state, liquid to vapor. Thus, heat causes changing state. After the water has boiled for a few minutes, the vegetables become soft and their taste changes. That is, the vegetables get cooked. Cooking of vegetables is a chemical change. Thus, heat causes chemical changes. Next, if the water is examined under a powerful microscope before and after boiling, it is found that many bacteria that were earlier present in the water have died. Thus, heat affects living organisms. This is because every organism can tolerate a definite range of temperature. Its activities and survival get affected at temperatures higher or lower than the normal temperature. New topic, expansion. Before starting expansion, I would like to explain you about the arrangement of molecules in solid, liquid and gas. In solid, molecules are tightly packed to one another. In liquid, molecules are loosely packed in comparison to solid. In gas, molecules are very far from one another. So, this is the reason that gaseous particles move freely at high speeds. Liquid particles also move one another because particles are loosely packed, or you may say there is little space between particles. But in solid, particles cannot move one another. Why? Because its particles are tightly packed. Now let's understand expansion. When we heat a substance, the movement of its molecules increases. This increases the average distance between the molecules. Therefore, the space occupied by the molecules, that is the volume of the substance, increases. So we say that heat causes expansion. Now let's see how expansion in solids occurs. To show this, we perform an activity. This is a ring and ball apparatus. We take it. This apparatus consists of a metal ring and a metal ball. At normal temperature, that ball just passes through the ring. Now you see in this figure. Now we heat the ball and try to pass it through the ring. It will not pass through. The ball has expanded on heating. Cool the ball to normal temperature. It will pass through the ring again. So what we observe? This activity shows that solids expand on heating. Now, expansion in liquids. You know that the molecules of a liquid are not so firmly bound to each other as in a solid. Therefore, on heating, their vibrations increase more than the vibrations of molecules of solids. The result is that liquids expand more than solids on heating. Now, perform an activity to understand expansion in liquid. At first, we take a flask and fill it up to the brim with water. We take a rubber cork with a hole in it and insert a narrow tube into the hole. Now we fix the cork firmly in the mouth of the flask. The liquid will rise a little in the tube. Now note the level of the liquid. Now heat the liquid. We will notice that the level of the liquid in the tube goes down a little and then starts rising. It goes down initially as the flask gets heated first and expands. When the heat reaches the liquid, it expands and its level in the tube goes up. Now we cool the liquid to normal temperature. The level will go down again. So what we observe? This shows liquid expands on heating. Dear students, if the experiment is conducted using different liquids such as kerosene and oil, it is found that the amount of expansion is different in different liquids for the same increase in temperature. Now, expansion in gases. On heating a gas, the vibrations of its molecules increases since the molecules are not bound to each other at all. The average distance between the molecules increases considerably. Hence, the expansion will be more in case of gases than in liquids or solids. Thus, gases expand more than liquids and solids on being heated. So now, perform an activity to understand expansion in gases. First of all, we have to take empty flask. We used in the previous activity also. Now, fix the flask to a stand in an upside down position over a beaker of water so that the glass tube dips inside the water. Now, heat the flask at the top. As the air in the flask expands, it escapes out of the flask. throw the tube into the beaker containing water. Bubbles of air can be seen in the water. Now cool the flask as the air inside the flask contracts. Now you will see the water rises up the tube. This shows that gases like air expands on heating and contracts on cooling. The effects of expansion of solids in our daily life. The expansion of solids have advantages as well as disadvantages. So let's understand one of the uses of expansion of solids in the automatic fire alarm. Here, how automatic fire alarm function on the basis of expansion. So let's understand. The alarm contains two metal strips, one of iron and other of brass. Brass is here an alloy made up of zinc and copper, firmly bolted together. Brass expands more than iron on heating. Why? Because brass is an alloy. Therefore, when this bimetallic strip gets heated because of fire, it bends on the side of iron. Which bends on the side of iron? Brass. As it bends, the circuit of the electric bell is completed. So now bell starts ringing to give the alarm. As the fire is put out, the strip gets cooled again and straightened again. This causes the circuit to break, means without completing it can't ring. So now circuit breaks, thus switching off the alarm. Now the next example you may take. The metal caps on glass bottles can be loosened by pouring hot water. Why? Because it is too tight, it is not going to easily open. So we have to pour some hot water to make it loose so it can expand on heating and loosen and it can open easily. Dear students, the expansion of solids has also some disadvantages which cause problems. For example, you must have seen a railway track. The railway tracks over which trains runs are made up of iron, and iron expands when it gets heated. So during summer, the iron expands. To allow this expansion, a space has to be left between two sections of the rail tracks. You can see in this figure. If this is not done, expansion of the tracks can cause them to bend and they come closer. This can cause serious accidents too. Now, next example you can take. In a similar way, in steel bridges, one end is made to rest on rollers with enough space. Why? To provide for expansion during summer. Now the next, when very hot liquid is poured in a glass tumbler, the tumbler sometimes cracks. You must have seen at your home. This happens because the inner wall gets heated first and expands, but the outer wall remains unchanged. Why? Because it is in the normal temperature.